Hey, Jurassen here again, and we have set up dissolve toggle for the shirt already and the complete body dissolve. And in this video, we are just talking about how we can have both of these things work together at the same time. So, first things first, duplicate our avatar, move VFX controller into the avatar controller, and let's get into the animation logic. So, on our dissolve part, the complete body dissolve, nothing changes. We just move it up a little bit. Why do we move it up? So, logic-wise, what's lower in this list has more priority. And since the dissolve is setting the alpha value of the dissolve to zero all the time, if we would then have a shirt try to change this value, it has to have a higher priority. I will show later how it looks like if we don't set that up correctly. But for now, let's go into the shirt layer. And we have it already pretty much set up. I have disabled that because it wouldn't have worked anyway. So the main thing is shirt on appeared, it sets the alpha value of the dissolve. We look at it. Shirt on appeared. It sets the alpha value. We don't want that because as long as we don't do anything with the shirt, our dissolve layer should handle it. So we getting that one out. And just have our shirt on here. And shirt on has only the game object enabled. So set up the transitions. And make shirt on our default layer. Avoid defaults off, of course. We take a quick look into the base layer. It's still empty. That's what we want. And now we are setting up the logic. So we have now to keep in mind that we have two states where the shirt might be not seen. First would be if we are completely vanished, the shirt is vanished as well. And in that case, if we toggle it, if we are invisible, we don't want these animations to be played. So how do we do that? We just add another transition between the shirt on and shirt off states, which only toggles the game object. Remember? It only toggles like this. So, what we set here is a condition that looks for two things. First, do I want to take the shirt off? And second, is the dissolve active? So, remember, if we dissolve ourselves, dissolve equals one, meaning we toggled our dissolve animation. So we are looking in the condition, is the dissolve toggled? And if it is toggled, just go to our avatar and disable the shirt. The same if we go back from shirt off to shirt on. So we add two conditions. If shirt equals zero, meaning we want the shirt to be on again. And if the dissolve equals one, meaning we are invisible. We don't want these animations which have an alpha value for the dissolve to be played at all. So next we have to set up is shirt on into shirt dissolve. So we don't want exit time. And we add two conditions here as well. So we want the shirt to be off. So if we toggle the shirt, remember it equals one in that case, go into shirt dissolve. At the same time, if our full body dissolve equals zero, meaning we are visible, do that. And the same we do over here. We had the second condition, if dissolve equals zero. So with that, let me move the animator out again. We go into play mode. Look at our lovely avatar. Click on advance. And can full body dissolve now. Now we toggle the shirt. And if we appear again, the shirt is off. So, if you want to see our shirt, we set the shirt to zero. As you see, it goes into the animation and then to shirt on. So, let's dissolve completely with the shirt. And if we disable the shirt now, it directly jumps to shirt off and doesn't go into shirt dissolve. So, set it to 1. Directly jump to shirt off. And if we appear now, the shirt is off. So with that, we mixed the full body dissolve with toggle dissolve. And what I told you before, if the layers aren't set up correctly like this, meaning the shirt is over set over the dissolve, meaning the dissolve layer has priority all the time. Let us take a look how it looks like now. So I want the shirt to be dissolved. And it just doesn't work and simply disappears at some point. Because as I said, we do it the other way around again. Here the appeared animation sets all the time. You are visible. And that's why whatever we do here about the alpha value, meaning how much you are visible, it doesn't matter because this layer overrides it all the time. So let's change that back, of course, because we want it to work. And that's basically it. You can do it with as many game objects as you want. Just make sure that the dissolve layer for the complete body dissolve is always above everything else which is doing dissolve stuff. And with that, this tutorial is finished as well. Bye!